representative of their own, a synth. The man killed every rep at the talks. The Commonwealth Provisional Government was over before it even got off the ground. I took up in town not long after. I was damn lucky they didn't just tell me to scram right then and there.
Why'd they let you in?
Because I'd rescued the mayor's daughter. Gal of about 15. Pride and joy of the mayor back then. Man by the name of Henry Roberts. The young Miss Roberts decided she'd run off with some caravan hand she'd, known for an evening. Turns out the guy was part of a gang of kidnappers. I didn't even know who I was rescuing, just stumbled on a crying girl and four toughs. I took her home and the mayor dubbed me a hero, offered me a place in town. Lots of folks protested, said I was a spy, but he wouldn't have it. Taking up in the city was tricky at first, but I never tried to hide what I was, and people seemed to warm to that.
Connie Allen there with the...
You took down four guys by yourself?
Well, I didn't have to. Back then, synths were even more of an unknown quantity than they are today. I told them I was rigged to explode and started going beep, beep, beep. Hardest part of that rescue was keeping from laughing as they climbed over each other to get away.
Was it hard settling in?
Well, they sure didn't make it easy. I started off doing the jobs no one else wanted. I got more banged up being Diamond City's handyman than I ever did living out in the ruins. But I guess folks never forgot I rescued the mayor's daughter, so they started coming to me when people went missing. Wife runs off with a new paramour and takes the rent money with her. Talk to the synth. An upset father decides moving him and the kids to good neighbor in the dead of night's not the worst damn idea since the bomb. Go get Nick. After a while, the jobs got so backed up, they didn't even ask me to do the handyman stuff anymore. Hell, I was so happy to do it, it was months before I started charging anyone. I never stopped being Nick the Synth, but it was Nick the Detective folks came to see. It was about then that things finally started feeling normal. It took me a long time to realize that home is where you make it. And with some time and effort, this place can be home for you, too. That's a long story, but I hope it helps. Want to get moving?
If you don't live here, you ain't nobody. Got it?
I mean, the great green jewel of the Commonwealth. It's Diamond City Radio. Louis Jordan is up next. It's spelled Louis.
Wow.
But don't be fooled. This one I can relate to because...
The beer tastes like warm spit.
What do you want, Vadim?
I am glad you are willing to
place
help.
For a drink.
Unlike my deadbeat brother, Travis is a good guy. He deserves better life.
So, what did you have in mind? I'm gonna need some more in the way of details.
Ever been in bar fight?
What does that have to do with anything?
Yeah, out with it, Vadim.
I ask because I want you to help Travis win his first bar fight. Think you can do that? I want to stage fight here in Dugout. Nothing too serious. We make sure Travis wins and feels good about himself after. I want you to be there to help make it look real. What do you think? Sound good to you?
How would something like that even work?
It makes sense, I promise. I have contacts, people I can count on. Real tough looking, but they will take a dive for money. They confront Travis here at Dugout. You step in and give him push he needs to stand up to them. Then you and Travis take them down. Nothing gets too rough, and Travis is something he can feel good about. Simple, right?
Why involve me in this?
You have seen Travis, yes? He cannot fight alone, not even fake one. He needs help. You can help him. It's too late today for me to arrange. You come back tomorrow evening after 6 o'clock and everything will be ready.
Ever seen a Meyer lurk? Think a crab, cross with a tank, with a bad hangover. Deathclaw is where the real danger is. Don't try to outrun it. Just get something solid between you and it.
Ever been up in the stands? Let's just say they can afford a lot of clothes.
Just buy or sell whatever you need and get lost.
Hey, Vadim.
Thank you for finding Earl's
kill. I don't
kill.
Like you.
Can't believe the doctor would do such a thing.
What you gonna do about
it? At least we have liquor to drown our sorrows.
Can you just leave me alone?
I'm
not
like
interested in
you.
Fine. Fine.
What you gonna do about it?
Look, I don't want any trouble.
Maybe I don't like your little radio program. What you have to say about that?
The detective is back. You should have a drink, Gumshoe.
Can you just leave me alone?
Oh, what's wrong? Not so tough once you're not on the air.
Hey there,
maybe
pal.
I don't like your little radio program. What you have?
Everything
to say
okay
about
here?
Does it look okay? Because no, it is not.
I have no idea what I did to deserve this. I just wish they'd go away.
Why not stand up to them?
No, I mean, no, that would be bad. With these men, it could turn violent.
Don't.
Yes, but
nothing will change unless you make it happen.
It's not that bad. I can just deal with this.
Don't worry, I've got your back.
Well, if you think it would work,
you got spunk, kid. That's all that matters.
Okay, that's well. That's enough.
Oh, I'm sorry. You say something.
I said, that's enough. Leave me alone.
Look at you. Let me think about that for a second. Nah, I don't think so.
I mean it. Leave me alone.
Sounds like you were thinking about saying, or else. Were you, Travis? Were you gonna say, or else? I'm wondering what comes after that. What you gonna do, little man?
I'll beat you up!
Big mistake, Travis. I'm gonna destroy you and your friend here.
Where's security?
Damn!
Where's security?
Hey, security!
Oh, God, my jaw. Bullshit, man. Just
you
bullshit.
Ain't gonna last once you leave the wall.
This is
so
bullshit,
don't get you,
man. This is not what I signed up for. This ain't over. You hear me?
Look, just leave me alone.
Oh, hi. There.
Hey, Travis.
Whoa.
I can't believe it. We did it!
How do you feel now?
I don't know. I mean, wow, wow! I never thought I could do anything like that! That was crazy! Wow.
Hey, listen, thanks. That was really something. I think maybe I should go lie down now.
You're bothering me.
Busy here.
I think that went well.
And I can't get over crying over.
What, you lost? I ain't a tour guide.
It's all over but the grind. And nobody's crying but
I think that went well. Ready for next part of foolproof plan?
It's not more fighting, is it?
No, no. This part is simple. You have seen Scarlet, yes? She has worked here for some time. Now, I am just simple bartender, but I see things. I see how Travis looks at her, and I see that sometimes she looks at him. If someone who was not her employer suggests that she go spend time with Travis, it might do him some good.
Why do I have to be involved in this?
Think about it. I am Scarlet's boss. I tell her she needs to go see Travis. Suddenly she is thinking she is no longer just waitress. Just do whatever it takes to get her to agree to see Travis, and this will all be worth it. And you and I never talked about this, all right?
You run into feral ghouls, keep your distance. Mindless eating. The best part of Diamond City is honestly the lights. Spot those bad boys for miles.
Is that a pit boy?
Give my left arm for one of those.
You shoot people, mister? My dad's like outside to shoot people.
Miss?
I'm on a break right now.
Can I ask you something personal? It's about Travis.
Travis? Really? Did he mention me? I heard about the fight. Travis was... well, he was brave.
Yeah? Absolutely. You should really pay him a visit.
You think? I mean, I've definitely noticed him. Maybe... no. No, I couldn't just go over there.
Look, Travis is a nice guy. I can tell that you like him. And I think he likes you. Just go talk to him.
Okay, I will. I'll go see him now. Thanks.
You'll get used to Diamond City security being unhelpful. Just ignore him like I do.
This is terrible. Oh, I knew it. I knew it. He was up to no good, and look what's happened now. You've got to help. I can't do it. You've got to help me.
What are you talking about?
I am talking about Vadim. They took him. Those men, the ones that messed with Travis, they came back. Said Vadim owed them money, that they had a deal. He wouldn't pay, and then they grabbed him and said that they would make him pay, and then they just dragged him out. You have to do something. Please tell me you can do something.
Do you know where they took him?
No, I don't know. He's the one that has always dealt with them. I've tried to avoid them. Travis might know. You should ask him, please. Hurry. I don't want anything to happen to Vadim.
Up with my girl. She kept the cap off the toothpaste. Know who does that? Sip.
Hey there. What's going on?
Have you seen Vadim? He was grabbed at the dugout, and Yefim thought you might know where Bull took him.
What? That's not a funny joke. Like, at all.
I'm not joking around, Travis. This is serious. I really do need your help.
Wait. Really? Oh. Oh, man. Wow. Is this... This is because of what happened, isn't it? It's my fault.
No, Travis. This is between Vadim and those men. It's not your fault.
But if I hadn't gotten into that fight with them, maybe this wouldn't have happened.
Don't beat yourself up, kid. You saw how things turned out last time someone tried to.
Look, I don't really... I mean... I don't have a lot of friends. If Vadim is missing, or in trouble, or whatever, then I'm gonna help get him back.
All right. I'd welcome the help.
Good. I didn't want to have to argue about it with you. I've heard enough to know they're probably holed up at the old Beantown Brewery. We've got to go in there, show them we mean business, and then we can bring Vadim back, and everything will be okay. Right? I'll get a gun, and I'll meet you there. We'll settle this.
I'm on a break right now.
Thank God. You're here.
So this is it.
Odds are, if they've got Vadim, he's inside. We're gonna be okay, right?
You know anything else about this brewery?
Not really. I mean, I think it's where their little gang hides out. There shouldn't be too many of them.
Good. We'll mop them up and have Vadim home in no time.
Any last-minute advice? I've never done anything like this.
You're not having second thoughts about doing this.
Of course I am! But Vadim needs us.
Come on. Let's go.
What aroma is that?